that whenever you want.
My name is Stein Vidar Lee. I am from Norway, and I am 70 years old. I have been to pension now for 5 years. When I was in work, my job was in school mainly. I am a teacher, educated teacher, and I also been a journalist for about 15 years. The reason why I'm in Croatia now is a very long story. But you can say it started 22 years ago. At that time I was headmaster for in school for foreign people, immigrants and refugees. And I had I was responsible for Norwegian lessons for those people. In September 1993, we suddenly had about 90 refugees from Bosnia and Herzegovina. And at that time, I told you, I was working in municipality and with lessons for immigrants and people from other countries. And we started very, very quickly to help these people from Bosnia, because there were adult people and small children. And we started lessons for adults in the refugee camp. And at the same time, we sent the children to school. And some of the smallest, we had a small kindergarten in the camp. We try to make the best situation for these people, and people in my municipality was very, very nice at that time. Refugees got a lot of help, and we tried to make their lives as easy as we could at that time. When children went to school, we also try to find out among the adults, Bosnian people, who could have, who was possible to take a job as teachers. And we had different subjects in Bosnian language, mathematics, physics, geography, history, and you know, everything. And after some months, when these refugees got permission to stay in Norway, they have, what do you say in English, collective, for all Bosnian refugees got permission to stay.
Okay.
And after that, they had municipalities, gave them apartments, maybe small houses, where they could live and try to make life more comfortable than in a camp. And but after 1.5 years, in January 1995, the first refugees from Bosnia wanted to go back to their native country. And I'm not sure how many people went back, but maybe from our municipality and neighbor municipality, about 6, 7, 8 families maybe. But the rest of them decided to stay in Norway. And the first refugees went back to Bosnia in January 1995 from our municipality. But after summer 1995, I don't think many Bosnian people decided to go back. They wanted to stay, and I asked them why, and they said, "We want the best for our children, they shall have a vacation in Norway, and so on. But at that time I also was journalist in newspaper, and I was asking myself, what are these people, what are the future in Bosnia? And I asked my editor in newspaper, can I go and visit my friends? He went back and he said, yes, please, you can go. And I went, tried to go to Bosnia in March, April 1995. And my goal, my primary goal was to go to Sarajevo at that time. But it was very difficult. It was still war. And I had contact with one Norwegian humanitarian organization, Norwegian Refugee Council. And they had headquarters in Zagreb, and I went to Zagreb, and they helped me with transport and accommodation, and they helped me to travel to first to Split and then to Gradac. And in Gradac, truck drivers lived. Truck drivers from different countries. They were drivers with trucks with humanitarian aid to Bosnia. And I was one day. They said it's okay. You can go with us up to Bosnia in this convoy. And that there I made my first newspaper reportage. We were not able to go to Sarajevo, so I had to go back to Zagreb, and we're waiting for airplane transport to Sarajevo. But unfortunately they closed the airport, and I had no chance to go. So I had a couple of days. They took me to Bosnia in Bihać, to Velika Kladuša, and I also had opportunity with the convoy. We went to Konvic. So that was first year, and next year I also came back, and I went to Sarajevo for the first time. And after that, I was maybe 4, 5, 6 years in Bosnia. I also went to Croatia. I was in Vukovar, and I also went to Kosovo, to Pristina, because there were a lot of Norwegian soldiers in Kosovo at that time. And I've been all over Bosnia and many, many places in Croatia and also Kosovo to make stories for my newspaper. I was in Visegrad to look at the bridge, and I was also in Potoshare, Srebrenica, the first funeral, official funeral. So, I finished my work in newspaper, and I went back to school where I was teacher the last year in my career, and now I went to pension 5 years ago. But in the meantime, I think it was 7, 8 years ago, one woman in my town asked me, can you please make excursion for my daughter's class in school? She was in graduating class in secondary school. And because she heard about my traveling in Balkan, and I said yes, but I will do it my way. You shall not go on summer holiday to Balkan. You shall go for excursion. And I asked my good friend Hamdi Karalic in Sarajevo to help me. This is also a very long story because the wife of Hamdi Karalic, she was a refugee in Norway with oldest son, and they were my neighbors in Norway. So I went to Sarajevo and we sat down and we started to make a good program for this excursion. And we started, I think it was 7 years ago. And now, 2015, it's August, we have finished 15 groups. Two, three, and four groups every year, mostly every year. And the first years we had accommodation in Gradac, but after 2 years we decided to find another base for this travel. And we ended up here in Tirpan because the Karalic family, Ariana Karalic, she had summer house here from 1965, I think. Her parents built house in Putovila, and it was convenient to make program here in Tirpan with the school groups, because we know a lot of people here and it's more easy, it's an ideal place for excursions. It's a small place, it's origin Croatian, Dalmatian town, small place, safe place. And it was a very popular place for excursions from our town. So now we finish, tomorrow we finish group number 15, and 2 weeks from now, 10 days from now, we will have another group, the group number 16. But that will be the last. I will retire. And enough is enough. I always say everything has got its own time. So now it's the end. I'm so sorry, but I really enjoyed all these years.
Well, we'll try to find someone to help you take over. Thank you very much, Sten. Yeah. Stenway. How you pronounce your name in
Stein Vidar Lee.
Stein Vidar, thank you very much. Yeah.